I personally believe that it's not important for you to know a recipe first. You know, if you can understand why it is being done or a certain process is being done and not look at it essentially scientifically, absorb it, feel it. Why is a certain style adopted in a particular style of cooking? Understanding their culture, their lifestyles, you know, understanding their history is more important than knowing how to cook it. Cooking it, if you have the knack for it, it will come. That's a smaller sort of a nuance. If you understand the whole thing, then it will be very easy for you to accept thereafter the flavors, the taste, the final output. That for me is very, very important. So I've been lucky in that sense.
Listen carefully, new order. Table 32. Ek kaccha pepita aur chikotra. Ek pizza asko tikka. Railway kosha chops. Ek litti chokha baad mein aayega. Sabse pehle, kaccha pepita aur chikotra jayega.
Something that was interesting that was already playing on our mind since the time we had done Cafe Haksin, for example, was to explore further a lot of cuisines that an Indian restaurant doesn't explore. So that's where an idea came into my mind that why don't we explore something which is ancient, as in ancient, really ancient, more than 2,500 years old historically, and something which is more new, something like 100-150 years old. In the context of ancient, that's modern, and the only thing that connected all of it together was the basic thought of doing the food that happened on the Grand Trunk Road, which is basically brings into play a lot of different and very diverse cooking styles. The idea was to thereafter do it all in one place and present to people something which is very, very rare. A couple of people I have worked with a lot in the past. For example, Chef Haseem Qureshi, who comes from Lucknow, he and I know each other for at least 18 or 19 years. He brings on speciality of cooking Lucknowi khana the way it is originally done. He's a real-time master chef. I have tremendous respect and love for him, and we share a great rapport in that sense. As far as Bengali food was concerned, I found a really good talent in Jagannath, who although has never worked with me before, but because I have lived in the eastern part of the country, I could speak his language, which always comes handy. I mean,
thank you.
As far as Kashmiri cuisine is concerned, I was lucky enough to be doing a couple of projects a year ago, and I came across Malik there. He's grown up cooking with his family, who have been wazas, you know, the guys who cook wazwan in Kashmir. And that's how he's learned. He's learned it from his childhood. So despite his young age right now, he has a lot of experience of knowing that food. So he understands the nitty-gritties and the finer nuances of cooking Kashmiri khana. And similarly, so many other people. I mean, we're doing food from literally, if I could largely divide it, more than 6 different regions. There is a system in the kitchen. There is an unsaid rule. The chef is always right. But all of that put together, people are scared. People know that this guy has he has no tolerance for, let's say, substandard work, bad hygiene. So they know all of that. I mean, so there is that bit of fear that he may not accept something substandard when I can do better. But at the same time, I have a way of having fun. I personally cannot stay very serious all the time. I never lose the intensity, that's a given. But there are loads of light moments or lighter moments in the kitchen every day, every day. Couple of days ago, something got repeated that had happened, if I can think back 17 years ago. Obviously, there have been several such big or small things, but you approach a table thinking these people are not looking very happy with the food, or at least they don't have an expression on the face. You ask the server, have they said anything? Did you take a feedback? And then you get no answer, and then you decide to walk up to the table as a chef, not knowing what's happening, and you are expecting the worst, really. And the moment you approach and say, I hope everything is going fine with your food, and they all look up and they say, chef, this food is fantastic, and everybody breaks into an applause. I personally am bad at taking too much appreciation. It doesn't really go down well. But this has happened a couple of times that I can remember. Of course, there have been very high moments as well. But that for me is beyond what you expect. You know, that moment is fantastic. All you can do is, at least that's what I did, put my head low and, you know, accept it for the team, because without the team you couldn't have achieved it. But then those are the moments that keep you going.